Deixa o fosto. Realiza a música neste carro. E assim te dá uma metade na imensa peça de fosto. Luz like home to be a home body country is like heaven. You are glorious in holiness. You are fearful in praises. Glory and all be ascribed unto your holy name. In Jesus, much mercy.
Shout hallelujah. The Lord is good and all the time. Let us stand up in Jesus' name. Wonderful and great God, Jehovah is your mighty name. You are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the beginning and the end. You are the unchangeable changer. You are the reliable God. You are the all-sufficient God. You are the one that was the beginning before the beginning started existing. His majesty, His excellency. Father, we worship you. For there is none like you, and there is none that will compare to you. Oh, mighty God, we thank you. We thank you for this beautiful morning. We thank you. We are about to feed from your table. Father, Lord, I withdraw myself. And I present you. I reduce myself so that you alone can be exalted. Come down in your power. Come down in your might. Let everything we do this morning be to your own glory and to the shame of that frustrated devil. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Let us sit down. The Lord is good. I want us to quickly go to the scriptures. Let us quickly go to Matthew chapter 8. Let's read from Matthew chapter 8. Let's read from 23. Matthew 8, 23. I read. Then he got into the boat and the disciples followed him. Suddenly, a fresh storm came onto the lake so that their waves wept over the boat, and Jesus was sleeping. Then the disciples went and woke him, saying, Lord, save us, we are going to drown. He replied, you of little faith, why are you so afraid? Then he got up and rebuked the wind and the waves, and it completely calmed. And the men were amazed and asked, what manner of man it is? Even the wind and the waves obey him. Now, there are some things we learn from these scriptures. One of the lessons we can learn is there was a storm, and his disciples followed him to the boat. Remember, Jesus was not alone in the boat. His disciples were inside the boat with him. And there was a storm. I don't know the storm in your life. I don't know the storm you are going through. The whole world is facing storm right now. That is massive storm. People are dying. The virus is eating many. But as long as you have Jesus in your life today, that storm shall come to an end. In the name of Jesus Christ. Number two lessons we can learn from this Bible verse. Don't panic. Jesus is in your boat. As long as Dr. Jesus is in your life, you don't need to panic. Just call upon him. Like what the disciple did. What they did, they just went to him and said, woke him up. And he intervened and calmed the storm. You don't need to panic. As long as you love, have Jesus in your life, you don't need to panic. So today's deliverance is titled, Power to Overcome the Storm. Today, power to overcome the storm. Today, you shall overcome those storms in your life in the name of Jesus. I'm not hearing your amen. Now, there are different kinds of storms. We're going to look at them one by one. The number one storm is the current storm we are currently facing. The virus. The virus is killing men all over the world. No one has escaped. Shout hallelujah. So, there is storm of affliction. So number one, storm of affliction, sickness. Different kinds of storm. Number two, financial storm. Financial, it might be you might be going through some financial storm now, but don't worry. After today's deliverance, those storms shall be over in the name of Jesus. Different kinds of storm. Family storm. Family storm. There might be some storm going on in your family. Battles going on. But after today's prayers, that storm going on in your family shall be over. In the name of Jesus. Different kind of storm. There is academic storm. Maybe you have spent 10 years trying to write JAMB. Or you have spent 10 years, instead of spending 4 years in university, you spend 10 years in university. Today, that storm in your academics shall be over in the name of Jesus. Different kind of storm. There is ministerial storm. Maybe you're a pastor. You are going through different storm. You have prayed. You have fasted. You have gone to the mountain. But the storm have refused to clear. I have good news for you. After today's deliverance, that storm in your ministry shall be over in the name of Jesus. There are different storms. There is barrenness storm. Barrenness storm. Maybe you may be facing some barrenness right now. You may be facing barrenness that since you've been married, you've not had any child of your own. Don't worry. After today's deliverance, the Lord shall open your womb and visit you with the fruit of the womb in the name of Jesus. Now, important facts about storm. You have a pen, you have a Bible, you have exercise book, you can jot down. Important facts about storm. Not all storm come to destruct your life. Some storm came to clear the path. Not all storm come to destruct your life, come to destroy your life, come to put your life in a standstill. Some storm came to clear a path. Like companies that are producing masks, this particular storm going on has cleared a path for them. They are now making excess profit. Like doctors, a lot of doctors that have been that have looked for jobs for so many years. Because of this storm, people are now coming, hospitals are now begging them to come and work. This particular storm has cleared the path. So not all storm came to cripple you. Not all storm came to destroy you. You need to look at the bright side of life. You need to look at this particular storm that is going on around the world. You take it and revolve it to your own advantage. Because there is good in this storm. Shout hallelujah. Important facts about storm. There is some storm. There are some things you need to learn from storm. There are some few things you need to learn from storm. So see that. What do God want me to learn from this storm? Maybe God wants you to draw closer to Him. A lot of people are drawing closer to Him because of this storm. A lot of people have become born again. A lot of families. Some husbands that don't stay at home before, now they're staying at home. Some husbands that don't even know their children are now knowing their children. So there are things you need to learn from this storm. What is this storm teaching me? Is it teaching me to be closer to God? You need to evaluate your life. Think about your life. Sit down and think. What must I learn from this virus that is ravaging almost the whole world. What do I need to learn? There is a lesson. And one of the lessons is for you to draw close to God. Draw close to God. You can see, it comes and it takes people's life. The question is this: have you reconciled with God? Have you, if rapture happens now, will you make rapture? Will you make heaven? Or will you be abandoned? The church is yours. Important verse about storm. If Jesus was open, if the disciples of Jesus were able to overcome the storm, you shall overcome your own storm. In the name of Jesus. Important facts about storms. Storms don't last forever. Storms don't last forever. There is an expiring date to that storm. The storm the whole world is going through, the storm Nigeria is going through, the storm going on River State, this plague that is ravaging has an expiring date. And if the expiring date has come, I want us to stand up and pray, Lord, by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, you storm that has entered into the whole world, expire. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, you see, there is power in the blood. There is power in the blood. There is no power can withstand the blood of Jesus. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, you storm in the whole world, expire now. Open your mouth and begin to pray. In the blood of Jesus Christ, you storm ravaging the whole world, expire now. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, you storm destroying the whole world, expire now. In Jesus' name we pray. Please let us sit down. Important thoughts about storm. Storms make some trees take deeper roots. Storms make some trees get deeper roots. Let me tell you, this storm we are currently going through in the whole world, look at Italy, look at China, look at Spain. America now has the highest number. But let me tell you, he that trusts in the Lord will never be moved. Some trust in their chariots, some trust in their money. But who do you trust? As far as you trust in God, you are rooted. Because the Bible says, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You are under the shadow of God, and no evil, this storm will not carry you. Because you are rooted in Christ. You are rooted in Christ. You are rooted in Christ. In the name of Jesus. A bad fast about storm is during the worst storm of your life that you see the true colors of people who say they care about you. It is during that period you see the people that say they really care about you. Those people that pretend that they like you. It is through your storm, when you are going through whether it's your marital storm, whether it's your business storm, that is when you know the people that stand by you. People that say, I love you. Oh, not because of what they are getting from you, but truly they love you with their whole heart. They are standing by you. So it is through storm that you know who is for you and who is against you. Not when things are rosy. When things are moving very well. Not when everything is moving, that's when you know your true friend. No, you know your true friend when there is storm. Shout hallelujah. Important fast about storm. To be the best, you must be able to handle the worst. In your business, in your career, if you want to be the best, you must be able to handle the worst. Currently, a lot of countries are going through the worst. And they will become the best through this worst. Maybe you may be going through the worst in your marriage, in your businesses, in your career, in your ministry. After this worst, you become the best. I'm not hearing your amen. Important facts about storm. What you tell yourself every day will either lift you up or tear you down. What you tell yourself every day, what you prophesy to yourself every day, will either make you or mar you. What you keep telling yourself, I'm not this coronavirus, it will kill me or it will kill you. But if you say this storm, this current virus will make me a better person, you begin to speak good things. Oh, this storm I'm facing in my marriage will make my marriage will not tear. This storm I'm facing in my business will make me financially great. This is just keep prophesying those good things. As long as you keep prophesying those good things, that is what will happen. But when you keep prophesying negative things, oh, this sickness will kill me. Jay, does it mean that I will die without having my own child? Does it mean I will die without getting married? You keep prophesying negative things. Those that, as a man thinketh, so is he. When you keep thinking of these things, negative things, that is how it's going to be. Because the Bible says, death and life are in the power of your tongue. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Important facts about storm. When you spend all your time with negative people, one day you become like them. When you spend your whole time with negative people, people that think negative, every time they profess negative, then one day you become like them. You need to disconnect from those negative people. You need to associate with positive people. People of like minds. Shout hallelujah. Important facts about storm. You are not born a winner. No. Neither are you born a loser. You are born a chooser. You are not born a winner. You are not born a loser. You are born a chooser. You can choose to be a winner, you win. You can choose to say, look, I am a failure, you'll be a failure. But if you choose, say, look, I am a success. It doesn't matter my background. It doesn't matter my particular qualification. Oh Lord, arise, make me great. Let us take this prayer point. I want you to stand up and pray like this. Pray like this. Close your eyes. It doesn't matter my background.
It doesn't matter my
educational qualification. Oh God, arise.
Make me great.
It doesn't matter my background.
It doesn't matter my
educational qualification.
Oh God, arise.
Make me great.
Open your mouth and begin to pray.
My background.
It doesn't matter my educational qualification.
Oh God, arise.
Make me great.
It doesn't matter my background.
It doesn't matter my educational qualification.
Oh God, arise.
Make me great.
It doesn't matter my background.
It doesn't matter my qualification.
Oh God, arise.
Make me great.
In Jesus' name.
I prophesy.
Open your hands. I want to pray for you.
I prophesy.
It doesn't matter the background you come from.
It doesn't matter your family background.
It doesn't matter your educational qualification.
It doesn't matter
the situation surrounding you.
I stand as the prophet of the Most High.
I stand by the oil of God upon my head.
You must be great.
Amen.
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 In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what you have gone through. It doesn't matter the storms around you.
I stand as a prophet of the Most High
and I speak into your destiny.
This 2020, you must be great.
Amen.
What your parents couldn't achieve, what your boss couldn't achieve, you shall achieve them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you. Please sit down.
Important facts about storm. Storms can make you or storms can destroy you.
Everything is in your hand.
Storms can make you.
Storms can destroy.
There are many people that have become something because of the current storm going on in Nigeria.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, it's left for you. The storm can make you, or the storm
can make you very great. In the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. A breakfast above storm. If you hide from all the storms, you will never grow. If you hide from all storms, check this Port Harcourt. My village, they are attacking me. You run from the village, you will never grow. Hey, this Port Harcourt, I'm facing so much attack. Let me run away. You will never grow. You confront the storm and overcome the storm. But if you keep running away from battles, you keep running away from storm, you can never grow. The only way you can grow is when you confront a battle, overcome the battle, then you become great. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Important facts about storm. Never judge anyone's story by the chapter you walked into that person's life. Never judge that person. You don't know what that person is going through at that particular time. That person may be going through stuff. And because you walk into that particular person's life at that time, maybe that person's situation is not too good. Then you judge that person. Don't. Maybe that person may be going through a particular storm. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Important facts about storm. Some people create their own storm and then get upset when it begins to rain. Some people on their own create their own storm. They are the one in their daily sleep, trouble they don't wake up. They use their own hand and generate problem. Now when it begins to rain, when there is problem, they begin to blame witches and wizards. It is not witches or wizards. You are the one that created the storm. Shout hallelujah. Some people on their own, they willfully, lion is sleeping. They will go and start carrying broom to choke in the lion's nose. And when the lion now begin to retaliate, they now begin to cry foul. They begin to cry, oh, did they deliver me from this? Why they are the one that generated it? Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Important facts about storm. Your greatest test is when you are able to bless someone else while you are going through your own storm. Your greatest test is when you are able to bless someone when you are going through your own storm. You don't allow the storm to prevent you from doing what is right. You don't allow the storm, like now, Nigeria, there is a lot of storm going on. There is problem. This virus is ravaging. But they say, no, I will continue to do good. Even I will increase the good. Like now, in the opium free restaurant, by tomorrow, I say, okay, we cannot close the restaurant. Instead, because when we don't allow people to sit down and eat. You don't allow people to sit down and eat because social. So the best way is take away so that people don't sit down together. Shout hallelujah. They don't sit down together and have this social something. So we have to take away. Give them. We cannot stop doing what is right. Helping the less, because this is the trying period. This is when a lot of people are going through a lot of problem. It is for us as children of God to stand by them. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Important facts about storm. Sometimes you face storm not because you are doing something wrong, but because you are doing something right. Sometimes you face storm not because you are a sinner, not because you are doing something wrong. No. Sometimes you face storm because you are doing something right. That is why they attack. So if they are attacking you because of your righteousness, anyone here facing, anyone watching me, you are being attacked because of your faith in God. Dr. Jesus shall see you through.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. So,
amen.
You are facing storm now because of your. Listen, not everyone that is a sinner, not because the reason why you are facing this attack is because you are a sinner. No, sometimes because of your righteousness. Important fact about storm. No matter how much it hurts now, but someday you look back and realize that the storm really changed your life. You look back and say, change, I thank God for this storm. If not this storm, I wouldn't have been this who I am today. I wouldn't have been a better person. You just begin to glorify God. You begin to thank God. Change, thank God for this storm. So it doesn't matter what you're going through now. That storm is maybe in your marriage, maybe in your business, maybe in your career. That storm is trying to make you a better person. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Important fact about storm. Remember, God gives his hardest battle to his strongest soldiers.
Nice.
His hardest battles to his strongest soldiers. So you are a strong soldier. For you to face that hard battle in your business, that hard battle in your career, that hard battle, it means you are one of God's strongest soldiers. Shout hallelujah. Important facts about storm. Storms often prepare ordinary people for extraordinary destiny. I repeat, storms often prepare ordinary people for extraordinary destiny. So, maybe you are an ordinary person today. That storm is making you an extraordinary person tomorrow. That will make you. I remember when I was in Lagos, I slept under the bridge. Today, by the grace of God, we have more than 18 estates that are giving people, that are people are living free of charge. So now, that storm in my life have made me a better person. Shout hallelujah. Look at, I slept under the bridge. I was a cleaner. I was a security guard. But look at today. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when somebody comes to me and says, Pastor, please pray for me. I have not eaten for 2 days. I know what you are talking about. Because me, myself, I have stayed 2 days without eating food. So I know. That is why I decided to use from the offering and from the tithe to establish free restaurants. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is why I use from the free restaurant, from the offering and tithe, and establish free restaurants. Because I know what it is to be hungry. I know what it is to starve. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I have not been able to go to school. I have not. Because of financial situation. That is why I decided to use from the offering tithe to establish the first free school, second free school, third free school, fourth free school, fifth free school, 14th free school. And today, there's another one we're opening at Oyibo, making it the 15th free school. Because I know what it is. I know what it is for one not to have money to pay school fees. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now, important facts about storm. God gave you this life because he knew you are strong enough to live it. He knows you are strong enough. You have the capacity to live this. That's why he gave you this life. He gave you this life because he knows you have the ability to live it. So, if you are thinking of killing yourself, if you are thinking of terminating your life, don't do it. God gave you this life for a purpose. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Important facts about storm. When it is hard to pray, that is when to pray harder. When it is hard to pray, that is when to pray harder. When are weak in prayer. When the even the options to pray is no longer there. There is something that is about to go wrong. That is when you should increase your prayer tempo. That is when you should increase your spiritual life. Whenever you feel hard to pray, maybe you want to pray, but because of situation, because of the storms, you don't have the urge to pray. Something is about to happen. That is when you should increase your prayer tempo. A prayer fast about storm. When things go wrong, don't go with them. When things go wrong, because things are going wrong. It's okay. God has abandoned me. Let me just. No. Shout hallelujah. Things are so difficult. I will go and join secret court. Don't go. Don't go with those bad things. God has plans for you. He loves you. He created you in His own image, in His own likeness. He loves you so much. He doesn't want you to waste your life. Do you know that we are in the last days? Go to the scriptures. All the prophecies in the Bible have been fulfilled. What is remaining is rapture. Any minute from now, rapture will take place. The question is this: will it be raptured? Or will it stay behind? The choice is yours. You must not allow storm to prevent you from being raptured. Because all the prophecies in the Bible have been fulfilled. And he said, how can I be raptured? Upon every sin I've committed, I don't think God can forgive me. Who told you? The Bible says, all have sinned and conscious of the glory of God. I am a sinner. I was a sinner. God picked me up. That's what the Bible says. If my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face, then turn away from their wicked ways. Then will I hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. There is no sin that is too big for God to forgive. By the grace of God, I've been able to counter so many people. I've encountered cultists, armed robbers, kidnappers, armed robbers. They come with their guns. You can go to the Nigerian police and find out. They bring their guns almost every Sunday and they hand it to Nigerian police. And now they become good persons. Some of them have gotten jobs overseas. Some of them have gotten jobs in Dubai. Some of them have gotten jobs in oil company. They no longer have problems. They no longer robbing people. We have a center in Alum where we are rehabilitating people. We feed them 2 times a day. We clothe them. We open business for their wives, all of them. Their wives, their children, all, you can imagine. They were even, there are some of them that have 5 children. I mean, and they are armed robbers. 5 children, 6 children. They live inside the forest. You go and operate. But now, they are no longer doing that life. We have rehabilitated them. We have assisted many of them to get a job. They are now working. They are not doing legitimate job. Some of them are even now pastors. They are no longer carrying God. They are no longer living useless life. They are no longer kidnapping people. They are no longer shooting people. They are not living it. Let me tell you, by the grace of God, God has used opium to reduce crime in this state. By the grace of God. And I thank God for the state government. They've done a lot. OPM have produced. We have so many of them. These are killers. These are people that drink blood and eat flesh. But right now, they're no longer into those crimes. They are not living meaningful life. God is happy. Because God is interested in their souls. There are many of them heading. And the funny thing, some of them that have repented, truly repented, that are now pastors, they are doing very well as pastors. Very, very well. They are no longer in crime. They are no longer into crime. Shout hallelujah. So it doesn't matter the sin you've committed. We have gone to Casablanca. I, my personal self, I didn't tell somebody. I go to Casablanca, where these prostitutes did, and I preach to them, and I bring them. It's like this. This is an environment. A prostitute is here. You come to the prostitute and repent. God loves you. Don't commit fornication again. She will be sober. She will hear what you're saying. But as soon as you leave, she goes back because she doesn't have any other thing she's doing. This is the only way she's feeding. Some of them have aged parents that they are feeding. They don't have anything else. The only way they can feed is to open their legs. But by the grace of God, I took it. Because before I became the general overseer of Omega Power Ministry, I go to Romola every night to go and preach to them. And one of the problems I found out that many of them I preached to, they would say, okay, man of God, I want to repent now, but what do I do? I don't have any source of income. I don't have any way of feeding. I don't have accommodation. I live in the hotel. And I became handicapped. So when God, when OPM started, I said, okay, now, I am fully prepared. So I gathered money from the offering and from the tithe. I bought different estates. And now I go to this lady and I say, I'm ready for you. I go to their base in Joe, to the hotel. Without, with the risk, I enter into the hotel. When I do the prostitution, I say, now I am ready for you. Are you ready to give a life? And I say, yes. It's okay. Carry your bag. Carry everything you have. Follow me. Because there's a new accommodation for you. And that day, by the grace of God, I entered Cool Breeze. I came with the luxurious bus. And then they all joined me, put their bags into that place. I carried them to the estate, already furnished. And I'm telling you, we started teaching them the word of God. We started telling them, teaching them about Christ. Teaching them on things of God. And they're no longer doing it again. Most of them now, what we did, we preached to them, they gave their life to Christ, we baptized them, and started business for them. Many of them are doing very well in their business. Some of them have gotten married, and now they are living happily with their husband's house. God is happy. That is what we use the offering and tithe to do. We rehabilitate these armed robbers. We rehabilitate these sex workers. We give education to these children. Because some of these children, some of them are going to cry into different things. But now we bring them from the street because they don't have education. They don't have education. That is why they go into those kind of crimes. But right now, no more crime, because they now go to school. I was discussing with a pastor friend of mine. I said, do you know the reason why there is a lot of Boko Haram? Boko Haram is easily to recruit people. Let me tell you the reason. The reason why Boko Haram is able to recruit because of education. Lack of education. Lack of education. Education is black background. Now, somebody that is going to school and is aspiring to be a doctor or a lawyer, if you come and tell a person, go and put bomb or carry gun and start fighting Nigerian soldiers, they will tell you, no, I have an aspiration. I want to become a lawyer. I want to become a doctor. But somebody that didn't go to school, maybe the father just gave back to them 20, and all they do, every morning they carry plates and do aluminum jacket. If you talk to the person, come and carry gun, they will quickly carry it because they don't have. They are not looking up to tomorrow. They don't have anywhere they're going tomorrow. They don't have any vision of tomorrow. To reduce crime in Nigeria, education. If the government can put in 80% of the budget on education, crime will disappear. It will disappear. 80%. Not on ammunition, but on education. So, what am I trying to say? God loves you, and He has good plans for you. There's nothing that God cannot do. It doesn't matter what you have done in the past. It doesn't matter the kind of life you've lived in the past. He loves you. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now, to summarize, what must I do when what I must not do when I'm undergoing storm? Things you cannot do when you're undergoing storm. Number one, don't blame God for the storm. Never you blame God. ever. Number two, don't go with the storm. Number three, draw closer more to God. During this storm, draw more closer to God. Number four, avoid sin. Number four, five, cultivate the habit of praising God always. Praise God always. Then finally, connect to a strong man of God. A strong man of God, a man gifted with power. And every storm, so that when you have a strong man of God back in you, when there is storm, the man of God can stand in gap and pray and intercede and call upon God. Every great man in the world, in the Bible, they had a strong priest be by their side. So that when there is a storm, if Jesus was not on the boat, that boat would have capsized. But because Jesus was on the boat, he was able to calm the storm. It's good to have not just a man of God, but a strong man of God, gifted with power to back you up when there is a storm. But storms must surely come. Now, before we go into our deliverance, in case you would like to partner with the OPM, like the free education, which we are providing education to the less privileged, to the thousands of children, you can partner with us on OPM Free Education, Fidelity Bank. OPM Free Education, Fidelity Bank. And the account number is 41500409 33. I repeat, you want to partner with us in the free education, because we intend to open the free school in all over the world. Currently we have 14 free schools. We intend to open more free schools in every poor location around the world. So you can partner Fidelity Bank. Account number is 41500409 33. 41500409 33. Now, in case you want to pay your tithe, because God is happy with OPM, we use the tithe to do the work of God. Many lives have been saved. The free education, the free school, so many rehabilitations. We are rehabilitating the militant, ex-militant, armed robbers. You can partner by paying your tithe in OPM. Fidelity Bank. You can pay your tithe or offering. You can send it through transfer. Fidelity Bank. OPM headquarters. Account number is 411-00-37-054. I repeat, 411-00-37-054. Last, 411-00-37-054. Fidelity Bank. OPM. Now, look at the free hospital. A lot of women are going there to deliver. Whether you are a Muslim, whether you are a Christian, if you hear stories, some late girls that want to go and abort because they don't have money in order to pay for hospital bill. Because in the OPM free hospital, both CS delivery and normal delivery is free. We provide everything free. So, want to partner with the OPM Free Hospital, OPM Free Specialist Hospital. It is a Fidelity Bank. The account number is 411-00-80-311. I repeat, 411-00-80-311. That is for the OPM Free Specialist Hospital. 411-00-80-311.
free hospital, providing free antenatal, including post-delivery, free of charge for everybody. No matter whether you're a Catholic, you're Anglican, no matter the religion, whether you're a Muslim, whether you're a Christian, just walk into the hospital and you register for antenatal and deliver. It is absolutely free. This is what early missionaries came. When the early missionaries came to Africa, they came with free hospital. Because that is the main origin of Christianity. They shared everything in common. The early Christians shared everything in common. So, and when the missionaries came to Africa, they came with free school. But now, schools now are so expensive, especially church schools. But it means they came with free school. They came with free hospital. But it's no longer that. Now, we have very expensive hospital built by churches. We have very expensive school built by churches. Shout hallelujah. So the right thing needs to be done. And by the way, we're doing the right thing. And when you partner with OPM, you join the right thing. Now we're going to pray. Shout hallelujah. I don't know the storm you are going through, but today, mark the end of that storm. Let us stand up. The Bible says, if my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn away from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and I'll forgive their sins and I will heal their land. It doesn't matter what the sins you've committed. You're watching me. You are not brother. You know, go to rob people. God is giving you his conscience. You have to repent now. Because the next robbery you will go, you will not come back alive. You're a kidnapper, you are listening to me. God, Jesus is calling you. He started an unlocking. Give your life to Christ. Because the next kidnapping you are going, you may not come back alive. It is time to give your life to Christ. It is Jesus loves you. Bible says, for God so loved the world, me and you, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have an everlasting life. I want you to kneel down now. Talk to God. And say, I'm sorry. Ask God to forgive you. Any way you have sinned against him, ask him to forgive you. Say, Father, I am sorry. Forgive me. Any sin I've committed that I've brought in this storm in my life, any sin I've committed that I've brought in this storm in my life, oh Lord, forgive. Oh Lord, forgive. Oh Lord, anywhere I've opened door for storms to come into my life, oh Lord, forgive. In Jesus' name. Let me repeat after me. Father Lord, I am a sinner. I have sinned against you. And I've done so many terrible things against you. Have mercy upon me. Forgive me my sins. Remove my name from the book of death. And transfer to the book of life. I promise, starting from today, I will never go back to my old ways again. I will never go back to my sins again. Give me a second chance. In Jesus' name. Wonderful and great God, he said, Lord, if my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face, I tell them for their wicked ways, the way from heaven, and I'll forgive them and heal their land. Heal the land of children today. Cleanse them. Wash them. Let them matter as do. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Congratulations. You're not a new creature. All things have passed away and the time come in. Stand up and pray like this. Every mistake I made yesterday.
Every mistake I made yesterday.
That have opened the door of storms against me.
That have opened the door of storms against me.
Be nullified now by the blood of Jesus. Every mistake I made yesterday. That have opened door for storms against me. Be nullified now by the blood of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Yes. 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 In Jesus' name, pray. Pray like this.
Every storm
coming from my enemies to cripple me,
scatter.
Every
enemies.
Coming from my enemies.
To cripple me.
To cripple me.
Scatter by fire. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Yes. From my enemies. To cripple me. Scatter by fire. Every storm coming from my enemies to cripple me, scatter by fire. Every storm coming from my enemies to cripple me, scatter by fire. Every storm coming from my enemies to cripple me, scatter by fire. Every storm coming from my enemies to cripple me. In Jesus' name, pray. I'm getting a message. Somebody here, the storm you are currently going through, I don't know who you are, but Lord, just listen this to me right now. You're watching me. From our brother. The storm you are going through right now is an inherited storm. You inherited it from your father's house. The same storm is going on in your family. Pray that this.
Every storm.
I inherited from my father's house. Scatter by fire. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Yes. 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 In Jesus' name, pray. I'm getting a message. Somebody, you're facing storm in your health. Yes. You are going through health issues. But God just ministered to me that He's about to heal you now. Now lay your hand in any way you have any affliction. Anywhere you have an affliction. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Let your power enter into this head. Raise one hand or put one on the chest. Put one hand on the chest and raise the right hand up. Father, let your power now enter into this head. Now, yes. Let your power enter into this head now. Jesus. Jesus, to power enter the sons now in the name of Jesus. Now open your hands, open your eyes. Now hit that hand which I have prayed for the power of God to enter. Hit it 3 times on your chest. Oh yeah. Close your eyes. Father, right now I command this affliction in the name of Jesus, because at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. Yes. Anything that God has not planted shall be rooted out. Now you affliction from the pit of hell, in the name of Jesus, I command you to jump out of this body now. In the name of Jesus. You cancer, in the name of Jesus. Come out. Yes. You are looking for food on the womb. Lay hand on your womb. I want to speak life into that womb right now. Hit that womb 3 times. Hit it 3 times. Hit it. Yes. Oh yeah. Receive power to conceive. Receive power to conceive. In the name of Jesus. You are facing financial issues. You are facing financial problems. Oh yeah. Lay your hand on your forehead. I want to speak favor. You face rejection, disappointment in marriage, in finance. Right now, I command favor unto this case. Yes. I speak between now and 30 days. Receive that your desired financial breakthrough. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. Anywhere you have faced rejection, anywhere you have faced disappointment, anywhere you have faced promise and fail, today, by the power in the blood of Jesus, I command to receive favor. Receive favor. Receive favor. Receive favor. Receive favor. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. Aha. There's somebody here with diabetes. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I curse that diabetes by the power in the blood of Jesus to die to the root in the name of Jesus Christ. There's somebody here. You defecate blood. Right now, I command that blood that is dead generating blood. Yes. Jesus. I command that blood that generator generating blood. Yes. Oh yeah. No more. I command that blood to cease.
I command that blood to cease. I command that blood to cease. I command that blood to cease. I command that blood to cease. I command that blood to cease. I command that blood to cease now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes.
You that have been abandoned by your divine helper, all your divine helper that abandoned you now, I command them to reconnect back to you. Reconnect back to you. Reconnect back to you. In the name of Jesus. There is somebody watching me. The virus has already entered into your bloodstream. I want to command that virus. Now, listen. Jesus is against you. The blood of Jesus is against you. You virus, hear the word of God. At the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. You virus from the pit of hell. Whether they call you COVID-19 virus, I don't care. Whether they call you COVID-19, I don't care. Whatever name they call you, there is a name that's above every other name. And that name is the name of Jesus. Right now, you convert virus in the name of Jesus. Whether they call you COVID-19, in the name of Jesus. Right now, be flushed out of that system now. Be flushed out of that system now. Be flushed out of that system now. In the name of Jesus. There is somebody here, they say you have HIV. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I command that HIV in your blood to be flushed out. To be flushed out. In the name of Jesus. That is a man, you are watching me. Your problem is high blood pressure. You have high blood pressure. You are tired of taking BP drugs. I come with good news. Right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command your blood pressure to return back to normal. In the name of Jesus. Yes, yes, the person with the high blood pressure, say, I drink the blood of Jesus. Say it now. Say, I drink the blood of Jesus. Say it three times. One, two, three. Now, I command that blood pressure to return back to normal. Return back to normal. Return back to normal. Return back to normal. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If somebody have an eye problem, just put your hands on that eyes. Right now, yes, let power transfer from these eyes into the eyes. Let power transfer, yes, into the eyes. Oh yeah, you eyes, receive your sight, receive your healing. Receive your healing, receive your healing, receive your healing, receive your healing. In the name of Jesus Christ. And somebody here, you are selling off everything you have gathered all these years. You are selling it off. Right now, I command in the name of Jesus, every property you have sold, oh yeah, all the good things you gathered at a young age, you are selling them off, cough, financial situations. Right now, oh yeah, I command you to come back. 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 In the name of Jesus. And speak restoration unto you. In the name of Jesus. Congratulations. Jesus loves you. Those that want to pick assignment, you are free to come on Sunday. Next coming. So by the grace of God, I believe that by next Sunday, this virus is over. You can come by 9 a.m. on Sunday morning. Come and pick a servant. The servant is free. You don't pay any money. You don't pay any money. Just come to the headquarters at around 9 a.m. and you pick your servant free. And Dr. Jesus will visit you. God bless you. I'm expecting your testimony. Father, those doing assignment, I close your assignment. Those doing assignment, I'll close your assignment now in the name of the Father and of the Son and Holy Spirit. If you have your water and oil, open your water and oil. If you have water, or you get a cup of water, get, I want to bless it. I want to pray for the power of God to enter into that water and oil. Yes, yes, open your water and oil. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Yes, say blood of Jesus seven times into the water and the oil. Say blood of Jesus seven times into the water and oil. One to go. Blood of Jesus Christ. 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 Father, let the blood of Jesus now enter into this water and oil. You water and oil, be converted to the blood of Jesus. Anyone that is going to drink it, they receive healing. Wherever this water is sprinkled, miracle, healing, deliverance, restoration will flow in Jesus' name. So use the water and oil and just see to see you on Sunday. God bless you.
Yeah, don't do that. Are you still there? Cut off, cut off. Okay.
What are they cut off?
It's one hour now. You see, this clock is not correct.
When I stay, when I bless the water,
yes. No. Some of them don't move.
Don't move.
your feet. I must tread before your throne as someone loved, the doer of good things. You are worthy of my praise, the doer of good things. You are worthy of my praise.
That you are of good things. You
are worthy of my praise.
Oh,
gị onye eluigwe eze afụrụ ugwu okpuru. The doer of good things, you are worthy of my praise.
Ojiji jide ma wako biyama anana
in your healing and I won't come out. Oh, but I get your good, you run on ya. Who's the mechir on ya get me? Kime on ya get mechir. When you say yes, who can say no? When you say no, who can say yes? Walk up your ma, ndibuchi na pogi, ndibese na pogese, ndibuna na pogi na.
But you are of good things. You are worthy of my praise.
ti oku juru nonu ya uzi mechiro nyege meki mero nyege mechi. When you say yes, who can say no? When you say no, who can say yes? Wako biyama ndibu china bogi chindi beze na bogeze ndibu nana bogina weli wele luwa na sokuru gionye liweza furuku kukuru.
The doer of good things, you are worthy of my praise.
judge of the widow, who is like unto thee among all the gods, who is like the Lord,
the doer of good things.
When you say yes, who can say no? When you say no, who can say yes? Woko biyama, ndi buchi na bogichi, ndi bese na bogese, ndi buna na bogina. Weli weli luwa na sopurugi onyeli weza furuku kubu.
The doer of good things, you are worthy of my
worthy of my praise.
bobe a biko nara no me oye liwe. Malado shata lirales, e catalado shata. Mighty man in battle, great redeemer, the advocate of the afflicted, the strength of the weak, the judge of the widow. Who is like unto thee among God the gods? Who is like the Lord,
doer of good things?
bobe a bico na na no me a oye liwe. Malaro shata lirales, katalaro shata. Mighty man in battle, great redeemer, the advocate of the afflicted, the strength of the weak, the judge of the widow.
At your feet, I'm prostrate.